Okay, Charlotte, special moment for you coming up when you're in Sri Lanka. You're going to be the highest one-day cap holder in women's cricket. What does that mean to you?
Yeah, it's a very proud moment. I mean, obviously, I made my debut in 1997 in one-day cricket. So, yeah, all those years later and, you know, to be the most capped player in the world, you know, something I'm very proud of. And obviously some of the players who I've passed along the way are great to the game. So, yeah, very proud. But I'm not sure if it makes me... I feel quite old, but obviously only still 30 and hopefully playing many more games. And, you know, I'm really enjoying my cricket, probably at the peak of my career. So I'm hoping, you know, to play many more and just keep telling the girls I started young. So it makes me feel young.
What do you remember about that first cap?
Well, my first one-day cap was in 1997, but I'd already made my test debut the year before. So, yeah, it's also, you know, I dreamed of playing for England and obviously I got the opportunity very, very young. So, yeah, it seems a long time ago. A lot's happened along the way. It's been a long journey with a lot of highs and lows, but I guess more recently a lot of highs. So it's been, yeah, it's been an unbelievable journey.
When you played that first one-day, did you think that, you know, you'd be sort of sitting here now on the cusp of breaking a record?
I didn't think my knees would allow me, but yeah, I always wanted to play as many times as I could, and obviously, hopefully, at some point, captain my country. So, you know, I've reached a lot of my goals, and but yeah, I think, but like I said, I'm as motivated as anything now, and I want to obviously make this team, keep making this team successful, and myself as well, and hopefully, I've got the opportunity to do that this winter and with the years to come.
You mentioned about the highs and lows that you've had since that first cap. Plenty of highs. What have been the highlights?
The highlight has to be, you know, winning the World Cup in 2009, I think. And obviously being captain of the team has made it extra special, I guess. You know, I'd always dreamed of captaining England or winning a World Cup. And it was my fourth World Cup and, you know, I finally got the opportunity to lift one. And, you know, and I've, you know, there's been a few lows. I think more recently the lows of the West Indies 2010-2020 was a real, really big low for me. But I guess years ago, it was, you know, obviously not being successful in an England team, which is always, you know, you always aspire to be successful playing for England. And I guess for the first sort of 5 or 6 years, we weren't a successful team. At times, you know, individually I did well, but I think that means nothing if the team aren't performing. So that they, you know, they were hard years, but I guess I've learned a lot from that. And I guess I can sort of teach these girls maybe some of my lows, you know, how hard it was sometimes, but hopefully, you know, more recently, you know, it's been successful, which is fantastic.
Seems as if you're still as motivated as you were back then.
Absolutely. I feel like I'm at the peak of my career, and I'm really enjoying my cricket, really enjoying, you know, the training. I'm really working hard, especially now on my fitness side of it. And, you know, I'm really, you know, working really hard. So we've got a big winter ahead. Obviously, Sri Lanka's going to be a tough trip for us. And, you know, we're obviously blooding a few new players, which is great for the team. And then, obviously, the big one this winter is going to be Australia, which I know the team are all really, really motivated for. It's going to be a hard series. And I think it's one place, you know, I think for us, we haven't won a one-day series out in Australia. So, for me, that's the next thing for me to do. And you know, I know the team are really motivated to do that.
Is it nice that even so, you know, obviously you've been involved with England for so many years, that you still have new challenges, you know, ahead?
It is, you know, and I think that's really important at my point of my career. You know, I'm always trying to challenge myself, challenge the team, and I think to have that big goal of winning a one-day series in Australia or a 2020 series is massive. And obviously, ultimately, the Ashes is always high on our list as well. So there's no bigger winter than what we've got ahead of us. You know, and I think, you know, to keep having those challenges is fantastic. And, you know, like I'm challenging myself again with, I'm going back to opening the batting this winter. So, you know, that's something new for me. And I think that's always good for me to keep, you know, challenging myself. And, yeah, and I'm looking forward to that challenge. It should be good.
You mentioned about the shift up the order. What was the thinking behind that?
Well, obviously, Sarah's not touring this winter. And I think, you know, I've done it. I did it a lot. Early in my career when I wasn't captain. When I took on the captaincy, I moved down the order. But, you know, like I say, it's a challenge for me, and I think, you know, it probably disrupt the middle order too much if someone else to go up there. And, you know, and I want to give it a go again. And, you know, I think I do it in 2020 cricket. So for me to do it in one-day cricket is not too much of a massive change for me. I'm used to the new ball. And, you know, I've been batting three for Kent all year, and I've pretty much been going in the first or second over. So thought I'll give it a go for England again, and you know, and that's really motivating me, you know, training this winter, and yeah, freshen me up a bit, and I'm looking forward to it.
We've had some good moments against Australia in the last, you know, 18 months. Obviously, winning the World Cup in Australia, did well in the World 2020 against them in England. Beat them, obviously, in the one-day series here as well. They're going to want revenge, aren't they?
Absolutely, and you know, they had a fantastic World 2020 out in West Indies. So we know we're going to come up against a good Australian team, and especially in Australia. So I'm sure it's going to be set up for a great series. It always is. I know it's the highlight of always. It's always the highlight of my career is going out to Australia playing cricket, and especially with such a big Ashes winter for both the men and women. So you know, we're looking forward to that, and two 2020 games before the men's games are going to be fantastic opportunity for us again to play in front of big crowds, and you know, I guess get more exposure for the women's game. So it's exciting. This is why we play this, you know, wonderful game to play in those kind of occasions. And yeah, no, and I certainly it's made, you know, put the hairs on the back of my neck thinking about, you know, playing in those sort of big occasions.